Dictionaries tell us lots of things about lots of words, such as what they mean and how to spell them. But there's much more. Each word has a story to tell. A dictionary is filled with entries, and each entry contains information about a particular word. These entries are arranged in alphabetical order. So let's say you're looking for the word ripple. First, you'll find the section with all the words that begin with R. Then you'll use the guide words at the top of each page to find the page with the entry for ripple. This page has rink and rivalry as its guide words. Since the RIP of ripple comes after the RIN of rink and before the RIV of rivalry, we know that this is the page ripple is on. You'll find a lot of information about ripple, including how it's spelled. Some words can be spelled more than one way. At the entry for racket, for example, you'll see R-A-C-K-E-T as the main headword, as well as the variant spelling, R-A-C-Q-U-E-T. This dot between the P's in ripple shows you where you can divide the word with a hyphen if it doesn't all fit in one line when you're writing it down. Dictionaries also tell us how to say a word with its pronunciation. There are some familiar letters here, as well as some special symbols that represent specific sounds. You can find out what these symbols mean by looking at the key on the bottom of each page. Hyphens separate the word's syllables. As you can see, ripple has two syllables. The marks at the top or bottom of some parts of the pronunciation tell you that those syllables are stressed or given more emphasis when spoken. The first syllable of ripple is stressed, so we say ripple, not ripple. Every word has a job or function in a sentence, which we call a part of speech. A word can be a noun, verb, adjective, adverb, pronoun, preposition, conjunction, article, or interjection. In some dictionaries, the part of speech for each entry is listed as an abbreviation, like N for noun, VB for verb, and ADJ for adjective. Now, have you ever seen two words that are spelled the same way but have different meanings? These are called homographs. In this dictionary, each homograph has a separate entry. Their headwords look the same, except for a small number just before it. Ripple has two homographs. One is a noun, as in, there is a ripple on the water, and one is a verb, as in, the wind made the water ripple. Because they're both pronounced the same, only the first homograph gets a pronunciation. Many words have more than one form. For example, most nouns have a plural form. One ripple, two ripples. Verbs can also have different forms. The water ripples. Water is rippling. Water rippled. Adjectives and adverbs can too. Your dictionary will always show you the verb forms and adjective and adverb forms, but it only shows forms for nouns when they don't follow the regular add s or es noun pattern. So, there's no plural form at the entry for the noun ripple, but at the entry for mouse, you'll see the plural form mice. Now let's look at the definition. It follows a bold colon and tells you what the word means. The verb ripple has two meanings. Down at the bottom of this page, the definition for the word rivalry is followed by the word competition in capital letters. The capital letters tell you that competition and rivalry are synonyms. The two words mean the same thing. Definitions are often followed by examples of the word in use to help you understand the meanings and how they're used. Some dictionary entries have other features too. A note or label might tell you that a word is usually capitalized when used with a particular meaning, or that a spelling of a word is more common in British English, or that a word is always used in its plural form. At the end of some entries, you'll see other words in dark, heavy type that don't have definitions. These are words that are formed by adding a suffix to the main entry. At the end of the entry for proud, for example, you'll find the word proudly. The suffix ly is defined as in a specified manner. So proudly means in a proud manner. Sometimes you'll find a phrase in dark heavy type at the end of an entry. Here at make are make believe, make fun of, and make good. These are called run-on phrases. The entry's head word is the first major word for this kind of phrase, but not necessarily the first word. Some entries have a paragraph about the synonyms of the word. Price, for example, has a synonym paragraph that helps explain the differences between the words price, charge, and cost, which all share a meaning. The word synonym in dark type at the entries for charge and cost direct you to the paragraph at price. Many words in English come from older words in Latin or Greek. Those words are called word roots. Here at the entry for primary, there's a paragraph about how the Latin word primus, meaning first, gave us the root prim, which led to the words primary, primeval, and primitive. At the entries for primeval and primitive, you'll find the word root in red, pointing you to the word root paragraph at primary. Some entries include paragraphs that explain where a word comes from or how its meanings developed. The word pretzel, for example, first appeared in the U.S. in the 1830s. It comes from the German word Brezel. This word and those tasty bread snacks go all the way back to medieval Germany. The older German word, Brezitela, comes from an even older word in Latin, brachiatus, which means having branches like arms. What do pretzels have to do with arms? Well, you could say a pretzel looks like a couple of crossed arms. Dictionaries are overflowing with interesting information. Some dictionaries may look different, but every dictionary starts with a section that explains how its information is presented. So, if something doesn't make sense to you, you can always check the front of the dictionary. As you can see, dictionaries are more than a collection of definitions. They tell us the story of words and help us discover new words along the way. Now that you know a dictionary's secrets, it's time to pick one up and see what you find.